Hello and welcome back to Pentagon Vlog, the final week of them. Boy, this meat thing called me out. Pentagon Vlog, go here and burger up my for Friday, like the way Bomb should be. So, Friday might be a little weird, but we'll get there. Anyway, the first of two coming today in Ninky Ninja Fight Town, written by Kenny Burley. That's probably a weird drop name, but whatever. So, in the next episode, Pen and Friend go to Gekking Anime World, and the personal conflict in the anime world to, of course, go between the fighting tournament in order to stop ripping. Yeah, you know. Personal conflict here is that Pen is so constant about whatever other people like him, including the other people in the anime world. Yeah, it comes more to the small one, but it's there. So, I guess before I talk, I don't know, what more do I have to say about the anime stuff or the comic stuff? I guess the personal conflict stuff, that's a week and stuff in the cup going. You know, the format of the show is that there's a personal conflict that goes along with the crazy stuff in the world, typically. And that for the cup, but a few times, we can hear it kind of, as it gets worse. You know, basically, it's like, it actually doesn't work, I mean, that's more of that. Letting other people think of you bother you, because that's kind of like why Pen can't show off his true power because he's too self-conscious. But maybe he wouldn't be so self-conscious if people weren't, you know, laughing at him. And they can't win. In fact, when they find out he's self-conscious, via not Boon or whatever, they don't know anything. Look at the Kashi. When they find out that the rubber free guy, when they find out about this, they basically bash him for it and aren't understanding it all. And I get that the point of a particular character, well, of course, Boon and Boon's the one who's learning the mechan or of. Basically, the reason he fought the next combat paragraph from the party, he was not invited. Took out he won, and Boon just forgot. And Boon didn't get trapped out too much for the guy of all. Yeah, that was lame. Personal conflict stuff. Again, mostly working in a good moral, but I feel like. But to that was further that. Well, kind of that's a more attached to antagonist. In some way, you know, not teach moral, but apparently, okay, going back and get sick again. Like, that's weird. The Boon thing, actually, I don't know, people kind of form a legitimate union in that case. I feel like I could look past that because everything else was really good in this. It's an anime style world, and it comes to anime, I've seen a few, but not a lot, and I don't know, I wouldn't know all the tropes, but guys know more stereotypical tropes, and because all the stereotypes are in this, so, and I have a lot of people who are equally bended by parody game anime that go for evil stuff, be kind of mad, but they're still getting a really funny and stylized way. I think they got a lot right. They're going style, definitely, everyone is definitely, drawn. They're going to pick up a lot of characters, they're going to get Pokemon, definitely one that most referenced here. And they kind of make fun of a few things, like that Pokemon, I can't remember their name. One character, literally, But, she is voiced by him in Walsh, by the way. I didn't have to look it up. That clearly hurt her. No idea about the other two gang. I like how Kakashi, the magical girl, they kind of scare him. And, if ever they have the tote box from Toro thing, and then, Ripple went from that Yu-Gi-Oh, make it Yu-Gi-Oh British joke here, by a lot, you can make learning this one, and of course, probably even from some other, I'm kind of hoping for a few more Dragon Ball people really think of your fighting, but it's like, not that I would know enough to know, but it's like, Took a dialogue. There's a guy now. Everyone talks like a bad dumb all the time, and they're going to make a lot of jokes. Yeah, it's definitely not going a lot. You can tell they watch Sailor Man. They even like old anime. Like, they make fun of, like, the anime, not the stories of the anime. Like, yeah. Yeah. I do wonder if the show has a Japanese dub and what they're gonna do for Code. I want to see that. I don't know what I've done. I don't see any dub to a show. Yeah. So, I don't know. But, yeah, the anime stuff is definitely very fun. Look at a few obby jokes, but I totally like them. Like, with Kakashi, Doug from Magical Girl Transformation, and of course, it takes forever so long that she ain't got to make him to fight. Again, I like that. It's kind of about before that, she will, like, we'll fight. And they do forget a really funny joke, but I think I don't forget it. Going up to that point, fine. And again, it's a good joke to do with her. It makes sense. Yeah, Ribbon don't get busted, do you think? But definitely funny. You know, and I like how he kind of lampshade, you know, to get plot with the show, you know, which, again, I like that. So, overall, the prequel conflict stuff, alright, got some flog in there. One which I can forget, one which I really can't. But the anime stuff is really highly enjoyable. A lot of really good jokes. The animation definitely got that down. It seems like really like homage and parody, even if, again, who knows how much we had to get right, but I feel like we're pretty good, ready, and they get, go right there, really funny and entertaining, so I guess we have to go over the dialogue and comic stuff and better than the actual writing, necessarily, you know, and, like, again, they're not too big a bomb, but I feel like if the world was less memorable, like, in the Wizard episode, it was just like, yeah. You know, then it definitely would have been lower, but because we're able to go interesting, dialogue, and funny, I can kind of forget that. So, yeah, it was a really good one. And I feel like more people, if they appreciate it more stuff, might be able to go over the other stuff, you know. Yeah, but, yeah. but I've got nothing on Captain Mikey, right? I guess so, whatever. But anyway, gosh, so you and I get to talk about the other one. Go. Okay, now for our second segment, My Mischievous Gun, written by Pine Man can't pronounce that name. I'm sorry. Anyway, in this episode, Pen and his friend go to a sitcom world in which Pen is the father of family and Ripon is Mischievous Gun. Who and the boss is coming over for dinner and he wants a promotion. And Ripon is trying to basically get him fired or sent to Antarctica or whatever. Okay, yeah. Initially enough, Larry is not teamed up with the cup because Larry playing the wacky neighbor. But he's kind of similar to what not like kind of help out Ripon or whatever. This one I liked a lot. I kind of knew I would. Looking at two episodes, I was more kind for this one. But, because I may not know much about anime, but I know a lot about sitcoms. Particularly, this one more traditional style sitcom, but I kind of faded that one, that'd be amazing. But, in traditional, kind of like 15 style, slash 80, but the opening, that would be very full house. I'm quite the gag at the end, but I can't gunk him, I can't boost and Jerry Moline, you did there. It took a kickoff, they got the color bringing it right, especially with that style. We got the audience reaction from the laugh track to. They even got annoying too, not just the laugh track. I think most kickoff pairings would just do that, but here they do the other sound. Like even the dog sound. Again, they're legitimately actually pretty moving here. And so it's like, gets together, kind of have to continue throughout the whole episode. And I feel like they take decades, I don't think. So, yeah, and you know, took a humor, really funny. You know, again, very good call joke, but there's a lot of funny jokes. Yeah, playing off of stereotypes. This episode definitely more about Ripon, Pen, and the mom. And called Boone, I don't. And Larry, he gets pretty funny. I got the Yeah. I can't remember and you got a funny catchphrase. Good enough for dairy product. I'm gonna start getting that. And my Bukashi the talking teenager, and she gave some pretty funny joke, particularly at the end. But the Gunnar one, she boom the time around, fuck the guy, and they could leave the thing. No, but it took a plot, they don't quite. And, you know, the whole lot they don't get from the Kamika plot, whatever. But I'm okay with that. You know, I've been on and off walking into where Kakashi and Pain character, like, if I have a particular character, can get, you know, particularly provide you a joke while instead of being worried. Right, but I've mentioned that on and off walking in, but no. Not a big deal in this one. And there's a lot of great joke in the point because of how we make fun of Kakong and about general antic weak character. The cop could pull off like I'm not crazy Kakong antic like that like the one Ripon is doing on that Omega fan of, but because it's very heavy like the cool good pack and it's pretty funny but you know, and they do a stick of go you know, mission stuff and Monica no, but what gets me with Gepco is actually does get a nice story to it where, it'll pull off a lot, but they actually get complete monk at the end. But still keeping the comedy there. You know, I feel like the only thing to take away from it is that they do the laugh track and they stuff like drop down, do down for parody purposes. But when you have more friends, really, like, meant to be, like they kind of have it in there too. You know, it freaking gets it from cake, but, you know, it's a little hard. But again, the ending, it's really nice, you know, we even kind of get a little bit of, like, the backstory, like, the hint at it, which I, you know, which I really think, yeah, because I wrap over, that could, for that book, I think we've been actually doing some kind of nice, in some way, I don't care, yeah, how it happened, but they do it, they even do it in a top-line way, one really sweet way. And then we kind of come up with a nice cool story to be able to go to. Again, I feel like we can everyone back both like a parody and kind of mocking about a little bit of homage. Yeah, good, definitely homage could come in that end. Yeah, so in the anime one, they definitely be able to parody and homage. You can tell they have an affinity for the kind of one. You can tell they have an affinity for it as well, you know. Yeah, so a frog one, a really, really good one. Like, I don't much really complain about. Again, like, whole. But being tone out, I think it's been a problem with Hinko, I think it's fine in this one. And again, the only complaint you can have about how well the Sweet Moment portrayed, particularly because of being a parody. But I think it worked really well because it's really nice when it happens. Again, they don't do a good joke with it. And then they have to slow down too much when they have Sweet Moment because they're funny. So, over yeah. Yeah, because I'm getting better. And I thought it'd be good because of a good comedy humor, which I like. But yeah, go overall really solid pair up because the writing in the anime one is kind of iffy, but the anime stuff is really fun. And here everything works because of writing and the good comedy humor. Overall, really fun pair up. Go definitely highly enjoyable. Go a little fun for me and even again, you know. Anyway, I'll go tomorrow. I must be coming down with something because that's kind of weird. So, a few of y'all kind of had that, but, sorry. Okay. I'm picking up y'all, they're going to look into Wayne gearing up, but hopefully, for technical today, I get back up y'all coming, but probably in the week. Back, I have stuff going on. But anyway, tomorrow is that purple guy / Rutilda. I'm not excited for that first one. I'll explain why in that vlog. But, yeah, kind of fun. Yeah, but definitely kind of fun. So, even that first one could be interesting. So, yeah, see you tomorrow for that. And I guess welcome to the Wayne for the better vlog coming as well. Thank you, Glenn, for telling me about this. I'm caring, by the way. come on, Nicole. You're getting a new show. You should probably tell people about it. You know. But anyway, so I got calls for me tomorrow. I'm getting on some other time for Welcome to the Lane. Don't know when I'll get to it, but not today, though. Gosh, I'll see you then.